of advertising. KUHS is now a very successful advertising outlet with great results for your business or product. If you'll meet me, I'd like to say
100%. Are we live? Are we streaming? We're live on the air. Hi everyone. Got the one and only show, Renee, in the studio with us. Getting ready to go live. Give us about a minute. We'll see you then.
Well, just make sure you don't drink and drive, or you'll have a cop as a chaser.
Exactly, Henry.
I got exactly.
Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and
buzz driving.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over.
That's messed up.
Buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
KUHSDenver.com is DJ Jess with you. Happy Saturday, everyone. You know, we had a good show. As mentioned, we were going to have a very special guest in the studio. She is with us right now. But before we get to her, I got to introduce my man, the main guy of it all, Mr. Henry Archuleta. Happy Saturday, bro. Happy New Year.
Same to you, DJ Jess, like you always do it. You always keep it real and live and in living color. I like that. Just keep it going, Jess. You're hot and on fire.
We are hot. UHS Denver is hot and on fire and about to get a lot hotter with the one and only Miss Cheryl Renee.
Turn it up!
Turn it up! Love it! The bargain queen, Miss Cheryl Renee, is in the studio. Cheryl, so glad to have you in the studio. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you both. I'm delighted to be here. Delighted to be back in Colorado.
Yeah, you know, that's the key statement right there. Back in Colorado, you were out there in Georgia for a little bit, right?
Right.
How many years?
Well, you know, I left in 2011. I went to New York City for 3 years. And then in 2013, I went back to Georgia and stayed there for an additional 2 years. So I'm literally just back 3 days.
Wow, that's awesome. And you know what? This is your first radio interview? Since you've been back, right?
Yes, yes.
Of 2016.
Of 2016,
yeah.
As well. There's a first for everything. So, once again, Miss Cheryl Renee is in the studio with us. Very happy to have her. It's going to be a good time. So, let's get up close and personal, as we like to say. Huh, Henry?
That's right. You know, we're going to really grill her for a little bit, put her on the hot grill, cook her, put her away up there, and let her tell us all her story.
Let her sizzle, yeah?
Now, she left Denver, made everybody, you know, cry. You know that. Everybody said, Cheryl, where are you going? You went up to New York City. Now, New York City is no joke. That is the city that never sleeps. Tell us about that experience in two words or less.
Two words or less. Wow, you really put some restrictions on me there. No, you know, I actually, all my life, people have said to me, you need to go to New York. You need to be in New York City. You know, I'm a second generation entertainer. I'm raised in the business, in the entertainment business. And when I was 20 years old, I had my first child, and it kind of derailed that dream for me. But I always said that, you know, that when I got a chance, as soon as my youngest was out of school, I was going to hit the road. And that's exactly what I did. I think she got out of school. I think 4 days later, I was in my Ford Explorer and we were on the way. Oh, man, my truck was loaded up. I had stuff tied on the top of it. And I made my way to New York City. And I'm really glad I went. It was a great experience, but it was also a very humbling experience. You know, New York City, it is what you hear about. It is.
Did you sing out there?
It's got teeth.
It's got some teeth. And, you know, I met someone that said it thrives on new blood. I would say it thrives on young blood.
That's right.
And I was almost 50 when I got there. And
so you're the young blood.
Yeah. Well, my daughter ended up coming up there with me 6 months after I got there, and she's still there, and she loves it. I mean, she has no intentions of leaving. She's thriving there. It was hard for me because I'd always made a living as a singer. 34 years I've been singing for a living, acting, producing. So I really, in my cockiness, felt like I'm going to New York City. I'm going to get there and I'm going to work. And, you know, I don't care what people say. I've got my experience. I've got 30 years of experience under my belt. But, you know, it was hard. It was really hard. It was expensive. You know, I think I did well, really. When I talk to my New York friends, they say, Cheryl, you did well. But, you know, the thing is, and of course, thank God I moved there in the Facebook generation.
Yeah.
So I would, you know, I'd have maybe one gig every 3 months and I'd post my one gig and everybody'd be like, Cheryl, do it. But you can't survive in New York at one gig every 3 months, you know.
Right.
You'd have to be more or less doing it every night. Is that correct?
Well, at least every weekend.
You
right?
got to be
at
working.
At least two, 3 nights.
You got to be working. And I went there with, you know, my own personal stipulations of what I wanted, didn't want to do and what I wasn't going to do. And, you know, I learned a lot. But when I had a concert set up in Atlanta, Georgia, which I lived in Atlanta for 11 years, and I went there for 3 weeks and kind of had a break and hung out with all of my friends. But when I went back to New York, I just couldn't pick that speed back up again, you know, because
they are fast. There is nonstop go, go, go.
It's go, 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 go.
And you got to watch your money. You right. can't have cash. If you have cash, it's gone.
It's gone. It can suck up your money.
Wait a minute. What happened here? I just rode the rapid train. Well, what happened here? Where's my dough?
Well, you know, also, it's a city, you know, you have to pay your dues there. And from what my opinion is that it doesn't matter how great or talented you are, they're so used to people coming in and out of New York City that they kind of make you pay your dues. Because I have a dear friend there named Rome Neal, and I remember he said, almost 3 years, you're going to make it. And I thought, what a profound statement, because I think that's what it is. I think that you have, that, you know, they expect you to be there and to show that you're committed to the city before you can really get in. But, you know, you have to build a following. People appreciated my gifts and talents and my experience, but, you know, I couldn't draw a crowd. You know?
And there's so many people from all over the world patching into New York City.
Yeah, talk
and
about a great big melting pot. You know,
it truly is. I mean, you get on the subway and you hear so many different dialects. That's right.
So Renee's saying, what?
I loved it.
What's
I loved
up?
It.
What? Right. Talk like that to me.
I love that part of it, though, you know, and I fit right in, and I love the people in New York. You know, I smile at people, and I think I you know, I get a different first introduction to people because I do smile and I speak to people, and so I found that people smile back. And
it's contagious.
It's contagious.
It really is.
And so
especially
I didn't have
your smile.
Negative to say about the people of New York. I'm glad I did it. It was a lifetime dream, but you know, I would say don't go without, you know, having something there. I went there thinking I'm going to find work. I'm going to make a way. You know, and I think that was my. You know, I won't say my mistake, but it just made everything harder for me and trying to fit in. But I loved it, and I'm so glad to be connected to all of my friends in New York via Facebook. You know, and I would suggest anybody who has a dream to follow it and go for it.
Absolutely. You know, I've been to New York one time, and I've always told people it's the ugliest, dirtiest, most beautiful place I've ever been in my life. Because, you know,
and you get your own pet rat.
Right, exactly. I didn't see no rats, honestly. I didn't see, you know, there was a lot of dirt and a lot of, you know, trash on the ground. But when you go to, like, you know, the park and stuff, it's a beautiful place. There's beautiful buildings there. I mean, it was great to see Radio Music City, you know, Radio City Music Hall and all that stuff. And it's quite an adventure, honestly, in New York. So you survived it.
I survived, New York City.
Yeah.
Quick shout out to the world, Jesse.
Oh, wow. Look at that. We got
rolling 100 miles an hour.
We are rolling. We got people in Greece, Romania, Argentina, Turkey, Spain,
Chicago.
Trinidad and Tobago, Italy, and of course everyone here in the States. You already know Sherry Reed from Las Vegas is listening. People in California, and of
you
course
get that fixed.
I know, bro. I know. It's my twang. I don't know, but of course everyone here in the Mile High City in Colorado listening to the one and only Miss Cheryl Renee. You know, people are very interested in what you're doing now that you're back here in the Mile High. So
before we go there, let's get to Atlanta, Georgia quickly.
Yeah, let's get to
browse
Georgia.
Browse through that, and then let's get to the Bargain Queen deal that we got going.
We'll get to Georgia, and we'll get to the Rocky Mountain Love Tour. How about
yes.
Yeah.
Let's try to cover everything. Okay, let's not let her get out of here without spilling her guts.
I love it. Let's do it.
Victoria, Canada. Hello there. Rio de Janeiro. Woo, man, we are getting slammed big time.
Mm-hmm. I love it. I put this on my website, and I normally put the state, you know, where I'm performing, but on K for KUHS, I put Worldwide Web.
Worldwide, yeah. That's us. You know, we're going worldwide.
We landed a good deal today, actually, with Vincent Powell. We're going to be, we're actually partnering up with Channel 56, 57, and was it 219, Spanish language. So,
fantastic.
We'll be doing some great things there on TV there. So check that out.
Check it out, y'all. KUHS Radio TV Denver. This is Music Alive right here. DJ Jess along with Mr. Henry Archuleta. And I tell you what, this show, Cheryl, has to be one of the listeners' favorites because, you know, we go up close and personal, and they like to hear people's stories. So, you know, once again, take us back to Georgia a little bit.
Georgia, Georgia. The whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Okay.
See, Jesse.
We could go home now. Yeah. That's it for me. I did it.
Did you pay your cover charge?
Yeah, no kidding. Look.
That was $18 right there.
I'll take it.
Jesus.
Where is my chip jar?
Yeah. I know.
That's awesome. It'd be nice if we could do that virtually, you know, drop it in. And actually, we can. You know, next time we can put the PayPal account up there and you're ready to do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, just bring your phone in.
Hey, we do have it all set up. So.
Mm-hmm. So if you're streaming us live on KUHSDenver.com, you know, people are just bombarding the system because they want to look inside the studio and see Cheryl Renee. So our server may be going down, but that's okay. Just turn on the audio portion of the simulcast and you won't miss a beat. You know, it's being recorded, so we'll have it back on Facebook, so we won't miss a thing. So anyway, had to make that clear because we keep on going down on our stream.
It's only been,
you keep taking us down, Cheryl.
It's only been two times.
Oh, okay.
That's because we got a huge stream coming in. You can see it earlier. You took it to the Feed It page, and boy, we are just getting hit all over.
Getting hit.
They like to hear Music Alive. Music Alive is one of our most popular shows here in Denver because they want to see what guests we're having on. Every time we advertise, we've got a new guest on here. Everybody wants to see. Who's the new guest in the studio? Of course, it's Denver's favorite. Cheryl Renee. Let's continue on with this great interview. Jesse, you've got it going on.
We got it going on. You know, so like we said, take us back to Georgia a little bit.
Well, I moved to Atlanta in 1990, and I was there until 2001. So going back, it was like going back home. I was always drawn to the South. Even when I was a little kid, I was drawn to the movies and the books. Anything having to do with the South. So when I was doing a national tour and we stopped in Georgia, I stayed there, fell in love with the city, and moved there. You know, I move fast. As people who know me know, I don't let any grass grow. I'm like, this is what I want to do. I'm doing it.
What a sad thing, though. She did sell her SUV.
Right.
Oh my gosh, bring that up.
I had to throw that in. You know, we have to give it one last.
It's up close and personal.
Oh, yeah. My goodness. I had the same SUV for 10 years. It had 253,000 miles when
it's
I sold
still going
it.
Strong.
Still wow. going strong, you know, but I didn't want to come back home. You know, I didn't know if it would make the cross-country trip, but I sold it to a very dear friend who's a mechanic who has already, before I left, came over to my house to show off my truck, you know, now his truck, so it's in good hands. So anyway, that's why I'm on the bus.
So don't throw me under the bus, whatever you do.
Don't throw me under the bus. Just let me on.
Right?
And it's $2.60 as of today, riders.
Lord have mercy on my soul.
That's a lot. That really
you
is
think
a lot.
For a, no, actually.
It should be free, honestly.
It was free yesterday, which I appreciate.
Oh, yeah, see, now that's good.
They light gave rail. Me a gift. My yeah, first time on the bus, they gave me a gift.
You know, they told me, you know, I was out there drinking and driving on New Year's Eve, and they told me to take the bus home. I don't know how I drove that thing home, but I was so loaded. I drove that thing home.
You drove the bus home?
Yeah.
What the?
They told me to take the bus home, so I took an RTD bus.
Oh, man, we need a drum shot.
We do. We do need a
sound effect, please. Yeah.
For real, because.
My wow. God. That was so stale.
That
I
was
mean,
stale. That yeah, was I mean, stale.
It was so stale, it had lift.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Yeah. Wow.
Go ahead.
So you're out there in Georgia, Cheryl. Let me excuse Henry. You know,
I can't help
you get
it.
So excited in here. Yeah, you know. Yeah.
It's not the first stale joke I've heard from Henry. Okay?
That's the first one of the year, though, isn't it?
Yeah, 2016 stale joke time.
No, wow. I did. I had a fantastic time in Georgia. I was working this year with Kenny Leon, who just did The Wiz, Kenny Leon's True Colors Theater Company. I was the production manager assistant. I did that. I did some prop design for two major theaters, Kenny's True Colors Theater, also Dominion Entertainment. I was props designer for their show this year. You know, I was doing quite well, but it was time for me to come home. It was time for me to come home for several reasons. Number one, I've been working on this project, Bargain Queen, making a way for over 20 some years, and I've always end up putting it on the back burner. And it's time. It was time. And also, I have grandbabies here, my grand pumpkins. I have a 12-year-old who stopped calling me, hello, and a 1-year-old who doesn't know me. And I said, you know, it's time for me to come home. Mm-hmm. You know, spinning my wheels there. I was doing okay, not really prospering, by myself all the time in my house. You know, I also do marketing and promotion. I design websites. I do graphic design for different people. So I was spending a lot of time behind my computer. And, you know, it was just time to come home. So I made that decision.
So you were out there in Georgia and you dreamt up a little tour out there. Is that right?
Oh, yes. That little Rocky Mountain Love Tour.
And you know what? It wasn't so little.
I don't think so either. You know, everybody had the chance to go see you. They would.
Right? I mean, it was four dates here in the Mile High City. Two in Denver, Colorado, one in Colorado Springs, one at the Keystone Wine and Jazz Festival.
That was a nice one, too. That was right up by where we were at.
We were up there in Winter Park.
Winter Park. You guys thumbed your nose at us. Yeah. Okay. Hey, we're going with the big boys.
We were just, you know, getting down with Tower of Power and Babyface.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
that's
just,
nothing.
You know, those guys.
You know. But no, it was a great, great tour. Four dates here in Colorado. And, I mean, they were all free. That was the best part of this tour, is that they were free.
They
shouldn't have been free.
And the most welcome place is the Jazz and Jacks
facility. Mm-hmm. I mean, you packed that place out. You know, Sandra is a great, great person over there. And, you know, you had Miss Cleo Parker Robinson coming in, and KUHS crew was there. I mean, how was that for you, coming home and doing this tour, seeing all these great people?
You know.
Did that kind of push you to come home as well?
Well, I'll tell you, no. I have to be honest about it. When I did that tour, I was not thinking of coming home. As a matter of fact, I was planning tour number two. Maybe
right,
we talked
to
about
come
doing
back
it again,
the next year, yeah,
next summer. So no, realistically, 6 months ago, I had no idea I'd be moving home. None.
Then she gave us some serious thought. She had a dream.
Mm-hmm.
And she knew
a dream.
She comes back with a Bargain Queen, get on KUHS radio. That's the dream, and made it become reality.
Absolutely.
Well, so I'm so grateful to Henry and to everyone here at KUHS because you have a hard time saying no.
That's true.
You guys
this man has a hard time saying no.
He's a
yes man, and I'm so grateful to him. No, the Rocky Mountain Tour, it was all part of my, all part of Bargain Queen, Making a Way. It was very important to me that I be able to do the concert and that each venue allow free admission. Because, you know, people all the time would say, I would love to come see you, but you know what I mean? Once you pay for cover and you do the drinks and you buy the food and you pay for parking.
And
you
buy your lady a new outfit. That right there sets you back.
A flower too, you know.
Dinner.
But my campaign is geared toward the low-income working class people because I feel like we're left behind. I feel like the struggle, even if you listen to our president, President Obama, when he talks about the middle class. But what about the 94 million Americans who are dancing with poverty? What about us down here?
That's called the debt slaves. Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what? We're hardworking individuals who are trying to maneuver this capitalistic system in which we pay. You know, I look at my gas bill and, you know, I'm paying $12 in taxes. I mean, you know, it's harder to live today. We have technology, we have wonderful gifts, but it's harder. Everything is taxed. Everything is so expensive. People, you know, you can't just say, I'm going to pay my rent and I'm going to pay. You have to pay all of these extra fees. You got bank fees. You got, you know, and life is hard for a lot, millions and millions and millions of Americans. So my goal is to offer some relief, to offer ways, you know, after over three decades of living as a freelance entertainer. You know, I say on my commercial, I got skills. I do. I have skills. I have ways that I want to share with people that they can enhance their lives. You know what I mean? You might only have $20 left after you pay all of your bills. But guess what? I can tell you to show you a couple of places where you can take that $20 and you can come home with something for you and your family. There's so many ways here in America, so many outlets, but you got to look for them and you got to know about them. And so that's what Making a Way is all about. And that's why I'm home, because it's time. I love entertaining. I've been singing since I was a little kid, long as I can remember. But I'm burned out. I'm a little disillusioned with the music business. And at this point, what I want for my life, I want to help people.
And that's the Bargain Queen.
That's Bargain Queen.
Now, the thing is, you know, I was living right there behind McDonald's with my box. I moved it over to Burger King because the dumpster diving is a lot cheaper over there. You know, you get better stuff. Is it true?
Another rim. Yep.
That was a rim shot.
Yep.
That was an awful one, huh? I mean, that was so bad. I think these guys are going to kick me out of the studio.
Yeah, it's about that.
I'm going to go home and I'm going to reach into my sound effects CD and I'm going to find it and email it to DJ Jeff.
Give it to me.
So he can have it.
It's actually in here.
Is it in here?
We do have it. It's under sound effects.
Okay.
Now, just backing you up just a little bit. Tell everybody what, with the tour that you had, you emailed me. Well, you just decide a bar right there on Facebook. Your bass player decides to jump out of the gig.
Well, what it was, first of all, the first person I contacted when I decided to do my tour was Henry, because I knew that I needed KUHS as a media sponsor for my tour. I knew that he would put his 100% into behind what I was doing. But, you know, of course, with life being, you know, things never run smooth. The only thing I asked of the musicians was that they be able to do all four dates. And 2 days before I got here.
That's just 2 days. If everybody's listening, 2 days before she got to town.
Yeah, I got a call from the bass player that I was advertising on my tour that he couldn't do one of the dates. So instead of saying, okay, I said, well, sorry you can't do all four dates. Maybe burned a bridge there, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But anyway, called Lim Williams, my drummer, and he made a call, and Justin Francoeur came on board, learned all of my music.
And Justin, for anybody who doesn't know Justin, one of the top bass players here in Denver, available, ready to go, and was referred to Cheryl immediately. So,
well, he's a multi-talented individual because most people hire him as a guitar player.
That's right.
But he was fantastic for me. Great attitude. Learn the music. You know, I even said to him, you know,
wow.
I said, you know, this music, I've got some soul. I've got some. He's like, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Whenever he's a yes man.
Yeah. He Absolutely. Was a yes man. He was like, come on yes with man. It, girl.
Whenever you hear a person always just say yes to you, they're yes people.
Yeah.
And they will not stop till you're done.
I mean, her whole band was on fire. Ronica Cox on keys, Lem Williams on drums, Justin on the bass, and of course, Leonard Julian III on the horns and vocals. And
Who I brought here from Atlanta.
And you captured a beautiful interview.
We did have a great interview. You know, you mentioned during the performance that he did the vocals for David Ruffin on the Temptations movie.
That's right.
Now, I've said this before. Me and my brother have always debated on that, on whether or not Leon did the vocals or someone else did the vocals. So now, justice has been served.
See, you met the guy.
Jesse, I got to have this. He tells me, I go, what are you talking about? I've got to prove him wrong. I've got to go do the interview. Go, do it, Jesse. Yep. Get him.
So we got it live on camera, and we put that point to rest with my brother. So
okay,
thank you,
brother.
Cheryl, for bringing him on out. Shout out to Mr. Leonard Julian III. And, of course, Lem, he just got married and celebrated her birthday.
And Cheryl got to sing there.
You were there.
I did. I hung out with him all day, which was really special. You know, I've been singing at weddings as long. Well, I would say I probably started when I was 16. But it was my first time hanging out with the guys. I loved it. He was very sure. And that's it's wonderful to when a man is sure.
And, you know, just looking at how happy he was, and I made sure to do a sidebar onto him, tell him, you know, you made such a good choice, marrying such a beautiful woman for you, and you're a beautiful man. He, like, really liked that, you know, because it's true. You know, he found him somebody who, it looked like he was so happy in that wedding.
He found his match. Mm-hmm. He found his match.
That's right. And it takes a while to, you know, find somebody you really want to be with.
Well, you're lucky, Henry. You know, you got your girl.
If she's listening, she's going to say, listen to her. Watch when I get home. You know what? You're taking me to eat. Because you see what Cheryl, you got.
Miss Pearl, honey, you got a diamond.
He got a good one with that one.
Yes, he did.
Oh, don't stroke her.
I'm happy for Lem.
Yeah, it was a great.
So, Barking Queen. Yeah, Jesse, let's give us some Barking Queen stuff. Let's promote her show. When is your show coming on, Cheryl? Everybody's going to be. We're going to push this one hard.
We've been pushing it, like I told her. You know, I told her in the car. I said we've been pushing the show. We're excited for it. So yeah, tell everyone when it's going to come on board and all that good stuff, man.
Well, we launch Wednesday, January 20th. January. I struggled with that when I was doing my commercial. January 20th.
January.
I'm so articulate.
January
20th, Wednesdays. Every Wednesdays from 11 to noon. And I'm so excited about that, having a daytime show.
Yeah, it's a perfect time slot, honestly, with what we got here. Wednesdays are filled with just great shows. I mean, Janine Santana from KUVO, she's
Janine,
on board.
Woo-hoo.
She's got Vaya on here, and then the American Indian Reporter afterwards on Wednesday. So it's a
and
great
also
day
the
to be on.
Greg Rashid out of Washington.
Oh yeah,
DC.
Greg's on there too.
Oh yeah,
you know,
Greg
so.
And Chris Brewer.
Chris Brewer
Chris
and with their
Wednesdays are gonna be hot.
Yeah,
Wednesdays are on fire with the Final Take, which is a great sports show. Chris Brewer and Fred McHenry. So show will be right before that. So that's going to be great. So
yes.
One after another, nonstop throughout the day, all the way till 8 p.m. at night.
And, you know, we're just going to keep on pushing it. We're going to keep on keeping on, you know, how
Bargain
we're doing
Queen.
Here on KUHSDenver.com. So Bargain Queen, you got a website. Go ahead and give them your website.
I do. And just for clarity, the name of the show is Making a Way with Bargain Queen Cheryl Renee, because there's a Christian saying that says God will make a way out of no way. And when I tell you I have stood on those words, I believe that I can attest to it. And there's so many out there who think, how did this happen? I couldn't see a way.
Yeah.
I couldn't see how this was going to come off. But you know what? A way was made out of no way. And so that's the name of the show. The name of the show is Making a Way. And what were you saying?
Your website. Give
the
me
website.
Your website. Yeah.
bargainqueen.biz or makingawayoutofnoway.com, whichever is easier, bargainqueen.biz. And also on Facebook, I'm very proud of my page, which is called Bargain Queen Tips, Life Hacks, and News. And I tell you, I've got something on there for everybody. Everything I do, I scour the internet for stories that are relative to helping people, news. It could be anything, you know, about business, about tax, the best way to look for a job. It could be, you know, how to affect your decor, which I do a lot of decor. I'm an interior redesigner. So we're going to have a variety of topics and segments, and I'm super excited.
And you're also going to have some guests and people to help you out. You talked about maybe possibly Andrew Hudson with his job report that he's got.
I'm so impressed with Andrew Hudson and Andrew Hudson's job report. And what I'm going to do, each show will have a main topic. And the first show will be an introduction show, and I've asked Henry to be my guest on the first show, and he said he would. But the second show, I was going to make it about jobs, but actually that's going to be the third week, because when I was on that bus last night, I was so happy when I put my key in that door and got home. And I thought, what is more important than home? And there are so many people who are homeless. So many people are struggling, trying to figure out how to maneuver this new Denver, Colorado, this new expensive metro Colorado. So the second show is going to, the theme will be home, housing, finding housing, working housing, outlets to find housing. We're going to come with a lot of information to help people get settled.
So just like I told you, I moved my box. I've got it up for sale for $225,000 because of the housing is really high. Never mind.
Just gave it in that.
Right. He's talking about that cardboard.
Yeah.
Right? And that's true, right, Cheryl? Because this is what you're talking about. Because, you know, here in Colorado, the housing and everything, rents are up $1,200 just for a one bedroom. Everything is so high. And you're going to cover all this. I'm trying to throw jokes in there because the reason why it's true, you know, a cardboard box. I mean, you can't even find housing here in Colorado very cheap. I mean, the expenses in here in Colorado have just skyrocketed. And it's got to do with the, medicinal marijuana and recreational marijuana business coming here. Everybody's moving here by the thousands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 100,000 people last year. Mm-hmm. 100,000 new residents.
And with Cheryl coming out with this brand new show that we're going to be offering, Cheryl's going to tell you how to operate on virtually a shoestring, how to make things work, how to make $20 become $200 in a retrospect way of speaking, how to make things work, how to make it happen. With little or nothing.
Making a way out of
no way
at all. That's what we like to hear, you know? So it's been a pleasure, Ms. Cheryl Renee. We're going to have some good times with you coming up. I know we will because, you know, there's nowhere place but up from here, right?
That's right.
So we're happy to have you on board, you know?
Here at the KUHS studio, we're going to identify ourselves, www.kuhsdenver.com. A quick shout out to the world, Jesse. It's slowing down. They know we're coming to our end, but it's still sitting there for you to go ahead and give a few shout outs.
You know, we've had a lot of people from the UK tuning in today, so shout out to them. Spain, Greece, San Diego, California, a lot of people out there in France, in Canada, and in Germany, and everyone here in the United States. Want to thank you all for tuning in to this special edition of Music Alive featuring the one and only Cheryl Renee, our first Music Alive of the year.
Yeah, and wasn't it a treat to have Cheryl Renee?
What a way to kick it off. And I'll tell you,
next week,
sweet. Who
we got next week?
We got Seth Tucker coming in next week.
The one and only Seth Tucker from Denver's own Soul School. Going to be talking about her EP release, A Girl Named Seth. And, of course, her show going down at Jazzy Jack's February 14th for all you lovers out there. So that's next week.
And following that, Shelvis is coming in here.
No way.
Yes,
is
she's coming
she
in.
Elvis?
She's Elvis.
Yep.
She's a she.
Yeah.
So she does it like, yeah. And so I just negotiated it earlier. So hopefully she's going to say yes. And we'll have her on the following week. So we've got a lot of good artists coming in here, as well as Cheryl Renee today. I hope you enjoyed this segment of the Music Alive Show. Jesse, like always, you are Denver's number one VDJ. I was going to say something else.
I had to wait.
I was going to say something else. kept it cool.
I was waiting. Know what, Henry? Like we've said it before, no one can build a radio station out of a coconut other than this guy right here. So I want to thank Henry. I want to thank Michelle, Renee. This was kind of like part two, you know. I've interviewed you before over the phone. But to have you in the studio is way more magical and way different. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Have a good one, okay? Look forward to making a way with the Bargain Queen, Miss Cheryl Renee, here on KUHSDenver.com. Right now, going to ease you on in to the U.S. Top 20 syndicated straight out of Hollywood, California for his show, first show of the year as well. So we'll see you soon.
And also for those who are live streaming, we'll talk to you later on the Musical Live Show. See y'all later. Cheryl Renee in the house.
Woo! Thank you guys. So do I ramble too much?
No, not at all.
Okay.
There's no such thing as rambling too much. Well, sometimes.
Well, you know, I know there are times when